Hello, my name is Vincent, and welcome. In this episode, we're going to be taking a quick look at my Aeronautica Imperialis collection here at Bunker 6. Let's start with the Imperium of Man and their Imperial aircraft. They're actually deployed by the Imperial Navy rather than the Imperial Guard. There is a wide variety of types, including these fighters, but also bombers and land vehicles. And I must say that pretty much everything from first edition is actually made of resin rather than coming from a plastic sprue. And of course, whenever we're talking about resin, we're talking about Forge World. And whenever we're talking about Forge World, we're talking about detail. And these resin miniatures have excellent detail. Now, they're actually smaller than the second edition Aeronautica Imperialis models, yet despite this size difference, I feel that in some ways there's even more detail to these smaller first edition models. Now, of course, there are issues with plastic injection molding, where certain details will be missed due to the complexity of making a die for molding. But I must say, I'm a huge fan of the second edition models, don't get me wrong, and I do like the new box sets. But really, with second edition, I think the biggest complaint that I have is the fact that the scale is so far away from Epic. Now, of course, that's no issue for GW. They don't have any need to worry about a game system from 20 years ago and not having any scaling compatibility or continuity with Epic 40K or Epic Armageddon or any of the others. But when you're trying to make an Imperial Navy or, you know, an Orc Warg, you just want to have everything seem like it's together. And scale is a huge way of breaking immersion very quickly if things are all over the place in the scale department. And it is my hope that Games Workshop really will get round to making a new version of Epic 40K. Now, I'm not particularly concerned with the rule sets like a lot of people are, and of course there are a multitude of rule sets, but I've never played any of the games, although of course I do intend to at some point. But anyway, I digress. The real issue here with scaling, and if they did manage to actually do a new version of Epic 40K, is hopefully that with the new scale, they'll be able to tie everything in with Adeptus Titanicus and Aeronautica Imperialis to make everything in the universe seem a little bit more cohesive at this smaller scale. Now, with these presentation videos, I normally just show you models I've purchased off eBay or from Facebook groups which are not painted, but this is actually a project I'm in the middle of working on. I won't bother finishing this one on camera because it's, you know, not starting from scratch, but you get the idea. Also, I do prefer this Thunderhawk over the new one. I like how the windshield looks on this model rather than the two split-sided windshield on the newer version, but that's just my personal taste. Now, one thing that avid Aeronautica Imperialis collectors might be dismayed by is I'm actually going to be using custom bases on all of my first edition models. I don't play the game, so I don't particularly care to have the original counter style bases. I've actually sold a bunch that I had on eBay. Now, some of the bases will be completely designed from scratch and others will be pre-cast resin, but this is what this particular base will look like. Now, this model is quite rare, along with the one after it, which is the transport variant of the Thunderhawk. Now you'll see that I'm showing you how the Rhino would look underneath the fuselage or in the undercarriage section of the aircraft, but I didn't bother putting the little arm parts in this section just because it would have taken too long. But you get the idea, two Rhinos sit in the undercarriage of the plane and can be released when necessary. And aside from the obvious vehicular differences between the transporter and the Thunderhawk gunship, the other major variation are the larger front wings to sustain the weight of the Thunderhawk transporter. Now, we can see that most of the Imperial Navy aircraft are quite boxy and have sharp edges and a flat surface, whereas, in contrast, we have something like the Orc models, which are incredibly detailed. In my opinion, competitively so with the full-scale models, the details are remarkable. Another little nice detail that I think is included is the rear hatch can either be closed or you can have it look like a orc is jumping out of the back. And you can see that on the left side of this particular sprue. And here is another heavy bomber. As you can see, the wings are not attached. This is because I'm finding it difficult to find a way of storing these models while they're not being painted. So it's better to not attach too many things because the type of boxes I have make it very difficult to store things like these planes. Right, anyway, onwards. I stupidly painted these models black and primed them black, of course, so they're going to end up being red, most likely. So I may redo them in gray, but we will see. Now, I would say that putting these models together, pretty much all of them, can be quite difficult and tricky at times. Due to their age, there are warping issues. I've mentioned in previous videos how to deal with that. But generally, when you buy ForgeWell products, they do actually come with a rather useful first-time instruction guide for working with resin. Obviously, the most important thing to say is wear a mask if you're filing or sanding, and wet the model most definitely if you're thinking about doing any work on a resin model and you might be inhaling any particulates. Now, the second section is going to be a little bit of a departure from previous videos, for example, the Adeptus Titanicus video. I won't be taking anything out of the boxes in this particular episode because we're just doing a quick overview of the things in the collection that we need to get painted and finished. But as you can see, I've got a pretty large range. I think pretty much every box set that they've released so far. I thought this would be the cheapest way of actually getting all the different aircraft from across the new series. Correct me if I'm wrong. I do have a couple of ForgeWell things in here that will eventually show up, but I thought instead of buying all the individual boxes, I would just buy the boxes that are not in the boxed games per se. So where there is an individual model, I tried to avoid it if I knew it was going to be already coming in a boxed set. But as you can see here, I've got some of the ground assets as well. Very, very cool. And I can't wait to get these painted up too. I think these really help sell the universe and the narrative, especially when you're playing the game itself. A game, of course, that I'm still yet to learn, like everything else. But I'm sure I'll learn this before I'll learn Epic 40K itself, because it's set up as a board game style, and I'm a bit obsessed with board games, actually. Now, these are the individual boxes that didn't come in any of the box sets, and hopefully this was a way of getting my bang for my buck, as it were. So, basically, if anything wasn't in one of the box sets, it would be bought individually. I'd only buy one of each thing because I don't need a ton of models. It's basically just so I can have one of everything from what Games Workshop released. And of course, I've got to remember ForgeWell 2 has a few sneaky things that I'm yet to pick up, but all in good time. And with this second edition, I will be keeping the original bases instead of giving them custom ones. There we are, the Aeronautica Imperialis collection that I've been gathering here in the deep dark depths of the Bunker 6 Studios. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, maybe consider giving it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, maybe consider joining the Bunker 6 family by hitting the subscription button. We've got lots more videos to come, that's for sure. But all that's left to say is thank you so much for joining me. And until next time, I've been Vincent, signing off from here at Bunker 6.